In our last video, we discussed about atoms and molecules. In that lesson, we discussed about how that atom existed. So how that atom existed, it is existed in two forms. One is ion and another one is in the form of molecules. And in our last lesson, we discussed about molecules definition and what are the types of molecules. How many types are there? Two types of molecules are there. One is homoatomic molecule and another one is heteroatomic molecules. Those definitions and examples also we discussed in our last video. So we will continue that lesson in this video also. So first of all, you have to know the definition of atom city. So the atom city definition was here. See clearly. So maximum in the examination time, they will ask you what is the definition of atom city. So you must how to know the atom city definition. What is that atom city definition? The number of atoms present in one molecule of an element is called its atom city. That means the number of atoms present in the molecule, how many atoms present in the molecule, that is called atom city of that molecule. Means how many atoms are present in that each molecule, it is called atom city. So here I give some examples of atom city. See here, the first one is argon. So argon, that symbol I gave here, AR. So if you see here, how many argons are here? Only one argon is there. So that we can say it is an example for monoatomic molecule. That means only one atom is there. What is that one atom? AR, argon. And next one, if you see helium. Helium, that symbol also I gave here, HE. So how many heliums are there? Only one helium is there. So it is also an example for monoatomic. Means mono means only one, which is containing only one atom, that is called monoatomic. So if you see argon and helium, these two are containing only one atom. That's why we are saying monoatomic. They will ask you, tell me the examples for monoatomic. Helium and argon. These two are having one special characteristic. These two are noble gases. That means they won't react with any other elements. Already we said, what I said, atoms, these are not inactive, these are very active, those are ready to react with other atoms. But if you see argon and helium, this both does not react with any other atoms. So these are examples for monoatomic. And another one is, if you see oxygen, it is containing two atoms. That's why symbol here, how I gave O2, that means how many oxygens are there? Two oxygens are there. So it is an example for diatomic. Di means two. So how many oxygens are there? Two oxygens are there. Oxygen and oxygen. Two oxygens are there. That's why it is an example for diatomic. And that next one, if you see hydrogen. Hydrogen, how many hydrogens are there? Two hydrogens are there. H and H. That gives rise to H2. That means two hydrogens are there. So it is also example for diatomic. Two atoms binded here. If you see example for hydrogen. So hydrogen and oxygen, these two are examples for diatomic. And that next one is phosphorus. If you see here, phosphorus, how many atoms are here? Four atoms are there. PPPP. Four phosphoruses are there. So it is example for tetraatomic molecule. So, and next one, that last one I gave here, sulfur. Sulfur, we are symbolized by S. So, how many sulfurs here? Eight sulfurs are there. Eight atoms are there. What is that eight atoms? Eight sulfurs. So we can call it is example for a polyatomic molecule. So, if it is only one atom is there, that we can call monoatomic. If two atoms are there, that we can call diatomic. If it is three molecules are there, that we can call triatomic. So if it is four atoms are there, tetraatomic. If it is more than four, then 5, 6, 7, 8, what are there? Those we can call polyatomic. So it is very important definition of atom city, and examples for atom city also you have to read. This was in your textbook. So that next topic is chemical formula. So this chemical formula is also very important for you, not only in the 9th class, it is very important for you in the further classes of intermediate. So you have to know the basics of this chemical formula. what is the chemical formula definition? It is the symbolic representation of the composition of a compound. Means if you want to talk about, if you want to write about any compound, so we can represent by symbols. For example, if you want to write carbon dioxide, so no need to write the complete spelling of carbon dioxide. You can symbol it by CO2 simply. And water, if I said water, then no need to write the complete spelling of water. So you can symbol it by H2O. If I say sodium chloride, so sodium, S-O-D-I-U-M, C-H-L-O-R-I-D-E, not required to write complete spelling. We can represent by symbols, N-A-C-L. And KCl, potassium chloride, KCl. Like that, we can write by symbols. This is called chemical formula. It is that symbolic representation of the composition of a compound. Now we see the characteristics of chemical formula. Means, what are the rules and regulations we have to follow while writing time of chemical formulas? The first one is the valency. So we have to consider the valency. Valency or charge of charge is must. These two are very important while writing down the chemical formulas. The valency or charges on ion must balance. These two, for example, for hydrochloric acid, hydrogen charge is +1 and chlorine charge is -1. So we should balance these two. Is this balanced or not? Yes, it is balanced because it is +1 and this is -1. If we cancel this both, then what happened? Finally 0. So these two are suitable each other. HCl, hydrochloric acid. So we should consider the first character is valency and charges must be balanced. And next one is when a compound is formed of metal and non-metal, symbol of metal comes first. So if you for example, some compounds are there, those compounds are containing metal and non-metal both. So in this time, we should write metal first and after that non-metal. For example, if you see here calcium oxide, in this calcium oxide, calcium is a metal and oxygen is a non-metal. So if you want to write if you want to mix these two, then first we have to represent calcium and after that the non-metal of oxygen. That another example, if we see sodium chloride, sodium is a metal and chlorine is non-metal. So if you want to write these two, then first you have to write sodium and after that chlorine. So sodium is a metal and chlorine is a non-metal. After that, if you see here copper oxide, copper is a metal and oxygen is non-metal. Like that we have to write. See here, calcium oxide and after that NaCl and after that CO. If you see these three, this is also an example for atom city. This atom city, it is containing two atoms. One is calcium and other one is oxygen. At a time, if you see NaCl also, in that compound, two atoms are there. One is sodium and another one is chlorine. So these are examples for diatomic. So we can say, but sometimes if it is there more than two atoms, more than four atoms, then how to write these chemical formulas? So when, for example, when polyatomic ions are used, the ions are enclosed in brackets. So before writing, the number to show the ratio. That means if you want to write the polyatomic compounds chemical formulas, so we should enclose it with brackets. So we should close with brackets. So for example, I gave here calcium hydroxide. So calcium is one atom and oxygen, here how many oxygens? Two atoms of oxygen and two atoms of hydrogen. Finally, it is polyatomic. So what I did here, I enclosed that OH with bracket. So CaOH twice I wrote here. And after that, if you see next one is ammonium sulfate, that is called ammonium sulfate. If you want to write ammonium sulfate chemical formula, here see how many nitrogens are there? One nitrogen, four hydrogens, and I closed with bracket, and after that I gave two and SO4. Like that, if it is more than 2, if it is more than 3, then we should enclose it with bracket. So like that we can write polyatomic means polyatomic compounds. So see here, calcium hydroxide, it is containing more than 3 atoms, and at a time sodium sulfate, ammonium sulfate is also containing more than 4 atoms. So it is also example for a polyatomic compound. These we should enclose with brackets. For 2 atoms, we need not required to enclose it with bracket. So in this video we discussed about the atomicity definition and some examples of atomicity, and we discussed about the chemical formula definition and what are the characteristics of this chemical formula. These we discussed. So if you see this chemical formula, characteristics of chemical formula, the first point what I said, we should balance the valency or charges. Those balancing that charges or valency, that we can discuss in our next video. That charges balance is very important, that we can discuss in our next video. So read once your textbook about all these things was in your textbook. Thank you.